So if we want to stand and we'll look at our toes, there they are, maybe hopefully all 10 of them. I don't know, maybe some people have 9 or 8 or 11 or 13, I don't know, but wiggle how many toes you have, bringing awareness into your body, wiggling all the toes, lay down 4 little toes, lift up big toes. And as you lift up your big toes, lift up your quads and activate your abdominal muscles. And roll your shoulders back and down. And let the top of your head reach for the ceiling. So breathe in and out. Nice work. And then lay the big toes down and lift the little toes up. Good. Good. And all the toes lift up. And as you lift all the toes up, lift up all the arches in your feet. You have 3 arches in each foot. You have a big arch right here. Woo! And an arch right in between here. And then an arch on the outside of your foot over here. Lift all of them up. Wake up your feet. Activate. Good. And lay all the toes down. We want nice wide toes. You can spread them out on the floor. Sometimes, like I have toes that like to hide, so I have to bring them out. Let them know it's okay. Good. And lifting up the inside arches again. Reactivate that. Hands to prayer mudra. Good. Inhale all the way up. Reach. Good. Turn, yep. Go ahead. Turn the palms of the hands back. Clasp your hands. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Press your shoulders down. Lift your arms up and lower. Hands come forward. Inhale up. Exhale. Palms go back. Clasping. Squeezing. Lowering. Lifting and lowering. Inhaling when the hands are in front of your body. And exhaling when your hands go behind your body. Back down, clasp, squeeze, lower, lift, lower. Really important to lower your shoulders before you lift your arms off your back. Inhale up and exhale. Good work. Clasp, squeeze, lower, lift, lower. 2 more. Up in, exhale. Clasping, squeezing, lowering, lifting. Lowering. 1 more. Up. Good. And still feeling your feet firmly planted on the floor, as if you were a tree with roots growing out of your feet. And letting the arms reach up. Good. Hands come forward and up. Interlace your thumbs. And reach up to the ceiling. And pull your arms away. Activate all the muscles in your arms, your triceps, biceps, deltoid muscles. So you reach and pull. Good, and the quads are still activated. And the abdominal muscles are pulling in and lifting the rib cage up off the pelvis. Good, and change your thumbs. Activate your arms. Nice work, inhaling long and deep. Good, and then turn the palms toward each other. Unhook your thumbs. Lift up your right heel. And reach up as you inhale with your left arm. One side of the body stretching. Reach, reach, reach. Good, breathe. Feel space begin to grow between the ribs. Feel your leg pushing the floor away. Good, and then come back to center when you exhale. And as you inhale, lift up your left heel and your right hand. Reach, breathe, stretch. Good, lift a little higher. Beautiful, reach, good. And then come back to center. Now we're gonna let our breath move our body. So when the body wants to inhale, we're gonna lift up one heel and reach with the opposite arm. Stretching. And when the body needs to exhale, we just come back to center and rest. And lift up opposite heel, opposite hand. Stretch and inhale. Beautiful. Exhale back to center. Nice work. Letting the breath move the body. So just stretch side to side. Nice work. Nice and gently. More time on each side. Reach. And reach. Excellent. And then coming back down, we're going to do some waist roll. So hands come to the hips. We're going to bring the feet a little bit wider than hip width. Keep your knees soft And gently as you exhale, bend forward. And as you inhale, roll your head up and around in one direction, the body follows. And as you exhale, roll your head around and forward and the body follows. Big rolling motion with your waist and your head. And use your eyes. So when you come down, you can stretch your eyes. And when you go up, look up to the ceiling and let your body follow where your eyes are gonna go. Stretching your ocular muscles all the way down. Exhaling forward. Next time you come forward, reverse the direction. Rolling the head up and around, and the body follows, and the eyes. Looking all around your room, seeing your floor, seeing your walls, seeing your ceiling. Exhale forward. And when you come forward, round your spine, pull your abs into your spine and push the floor away with your body, with your feet. Good, coming all the way up, and then the arms come all the way up. Good work. Bring your feet a little bit wider, not too wide. We're just gonna, in keeping the knees soft, we're just gonna sway from side to side, just like a willow tree, strong and flexible. Inhaling up. Exhaling over. Nice work. Beautiful. We're going to change it up a little bit. So we're going to inhale all the way over and bring your right hand down to your thigh. And your left hand is going to reach out over your head. And your right arm is going to, reach. And you're going to exhale here. Good, and then you're going to inhale all the way up over to the other side. I hope this is okay for you, Cheryl. You adjust if you need to. Left hand comes to the thigh, right arm reaches out, breath in. As we exhale, we reach with both arms. Good, inhale up, strengthening your core all the way over. And exhale, reach with both arms. Excellent, inhaling up. Hand comes to thigh, reach overhead, reach out with both and exhale. Beautiful. Up and over. Feel your ribs working. Feel your abs working. Feel your arms working. Good. Two more on each side. If this is too much for you, just sway back and forth like we were doing before, like the willow tree. All the way up and over. Let your body be your teacher and me just the guide. I'm just giving you crazy ideas about what you can do with your body, but let your body decide if it is okay with what we're doing. Good, bring your feet back together. We'll do a couple balance postures. So let's just stand here and come up on our toes and slowly lower your heels down. And maybe this is as much as you want to do today. But if you want to go further, we'll go into the dancer. So the hands come up into prayer mudra and then they inhale all the way up over your head. And then as you exhale, the hands come down and the heels come down and the tailbone rolls back as you bend your knees and you come down here. Exhale. And push the floor away when you inhale. And push the body all the way up. Hands come up. Heels come up. Reach up. Nice work. And when the body needs to exhale, heels come down. Tailbone goes back. Heart, hands to heart. Body inhales, pushes the floor away, stands up. And exhaling down. So it's easy to remember when to inhale and when to exhale. When we do asanas like this, because it's like when we expand the body, we're creating lots of space for air to come in. So you inhale here. And when we contract the body, we push the air out naturally. Nice. And when you come down, Try to look straight ahead and try to keep, you know, definitely keep your heels on the floor. Good. Rolling the tailbone back. Good. Feel your legs so strong. We'll do three more. Beautiful work all the way up. And when we come down, we'll just rest here, down here. Just resting. Good. And bring your hands to your thighs and round your spine. You can bring your feet apart a little bit more if you like. So hands are on your thighs and you're rounding like a cat. And as you inhale, roll your shoulders back and down, tailbone out, eyeballs up. Inhale. Cow. Exhale, rounding. Inhale, arching, shoulders down, eyeballs up. Good, rounding and arching. Good work. Keep it rounding, keep it arching. Keep it breathing. Feel every vertebra moving and getting beautiful circulation in your spine. Stimulating 72,000 nerve endings in your spinal column. I'm thinking about courage, and I'm thinking about this whole past year that we've been staying inside and isolating. And I know that like every one of us has gone through some changes, and I'm thinking courage is like so key right now for us to keep going and not shy away from the challenges we've been presented. So let's do the lion pose. So let's do one more cat in honor of the lion. Then bring your feet apart a little bit more. Generally we sit down when we do this, but let's stand right now because we're here. So my feet are apart, my arms are straight, and I'm just you know, letting my arms become my spine, kind of, you know. And so the lion, we want to roar, and we're going to, it helps to clear our throat, helps to stretch our facial muscles and everything, and it helps give us courage. So think about, like, where does your courage come from, and think about your feet planted on the floor. Think about your hips, the very tip of your tailbone, your root chakra, all that. So we're going to inhale, and as we exhale, we're going to roar, and we're going to stick our tongue down to our chin and roll our eyeballs up to the ceiling. Here we go. Breath in. Give me a big growl. Two more of those. Good. You're very ferocious. Inhale. Good. It also helps if you have a little sore throat. It helps to clear that out. Let's do one more. And think about summoning all your courage. And if there's, you know, some virus floating around, we're gonna scare it away. Here we go, breath in. Good work. Or if there's somebody around us with a virus, we're gonna scare them away. Come standing up. Good. Bring the feet apart. I don't know how many feet. That's probably 3.5 feet. Your legs will determine how far. And your left. Right foot goes 90 degrees, and your left foot heel pushes back. We're going to press this hip back. See, square up the hips. Nice work. Breath in. And exhale, reach. Reach over your right foot. Reach, 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 reach. Good work. Breathing, stretching. Nice work. Reach a little further. Good. And now let's bend the front knee and sink a little deeper. We want this knee to be over the ankle. If it's too far over your toes, you could injure your knee. So we want to really strengthen the knees. Bend your elbow and bring it down on your shin and lift your left arm up in the air and look up and breathe. I love this song. All right, so if you want more, you can bring your hand down to the floor. Keep that twist going on in your ribs. Keep opening your heart. Good. You can stay here, or if you want, straighten your leg for more of a hamstring, upper groin, inguinal area stretch. Beautiful work. Excellent choices. Breath in. As you exhale, push the floor away with your right foot. Come on up. Beautiful. Turn your feet. Change your feet. Good. Left foot 90 degrees. Right foot 45. We want the heel of the left foot to be in alignment with the, instep of the right. Push your hip back. Oh, we forgot to copy our attitude. Here we go. Copy your attitude. So we stick out our hip. Good, and we reach. Reach, gaze down your long arm. Beautiful long arm, good work. Really nice form, you guys, looks excellent. Good, you can roll your right hip back a little bit more. So roll this hip, that's it. Good, and then we go to bend the front knee. Bring your elbow down and lift your right arm up in the air. Gaze up to your fingers, stretching your neck. Nice work, beautiful work. Drop your ribs a little bit more there. Nice work. If your arms are long enough and you want to bend your elbows behind you and reach up behind your back and hold hands, that's the final place of the garland. I can't demonstrate because I'm not that flexible. But, or as some people would say, my arms are not long enough, but I do have long arms, so it's not my arms that are the problem. Nothing's a problem. It is what it is. These forward bending postures are very warming to the body. So if you're feeling, you know, it's logical, right? You get in bed and you get into the fetal position if your sheets are cold. And if not, and you're warm, then the arching postures are cooling for the body. You can just watch a cat and see what they do when they're hot or cold. Good. Bring your hands back in front of you now. And keep the squat, and we're just going to bring now the hands around, and we're going to sit down on the floor in Paramakasana, the cobbler pose. Good. So here my hips are on the floor. I'm going to hold my feet with my hands. I'm going to round my spine as I exhale, warming. And I'm going to arch my spine as I inhale, cooling. Exhale, rounding. Inhale, cooling. Keep the breath moving the body. I'm going to change the angle of my camera so you can see me a little bit better on the floor. There we go. I'm going to get my little mat. There we go. Nice work. Rounding. Rounding. Inhale. Exhale. Do this with breath of fire. So we talked about, well, not with you guys, but so breath of fire, remember, it's a kundalini thing where you just really focus on your exhalation and you go. It's all from your abdominal muscles and you're focusing on the exhale and your body has no choice but to inhale. So you look like this. Okay, take a breath in, hold your breath, squeeze the root lock, that's all the muscles in your groin area, and your buttocks, squeeze hard, hold your breath in, squeeze a little harder, take a little more breath in, squeeze, and exhale, relax. Good work. Good. So the breath of fire energizes the body, cleanses you, gets your gastric juices going for your digestion. It's a fantastic thing to do. All right, so let's bring the heels in a little bit closer to our body. Press the shoulders down and press the knees down as far as you can press them down. Nice work. Love these loose hips in this room. Loose hips sink ships. That's what they do. All right, grab your big toes with your index and middle finger and thumb. Good, and then roll your shoulders back and down and just lift your heels a little bit. So this is step by step. If you already know this posture, go for it. Go into it. So you can balance here. So we want to get off the coccyx and we want to really bring the tilt the pelvis back so you're more on your sits bones. I hope this is okay for you, Cheryl. If not, we'll do some cat and cows. Okay. All right, and then one leg likes to lift up. Ta-da! There it is. Good work. And so sometimes we lose our posture when we're here, so bring it back. Press your shoulders down. Activate your abs. Activate the back, your lower back. Good. And we'll bend that knee and stretch the other guy out. Or girl leg. A girl leg. Who knows what gender the leg is? They say the right side is masculine and the left is feminine. Good, and then back to center, and both, if you want. If not, if that's ridiculous for you, just keep your feet here. Just inch by inch. If this is even ridiculous, go here, wherever you want to be. Your body will determine. Nice work. Breathing in,
and breathing out. If it's uncomfortable grabbing your big toes, you can grab the instep. Yeah, there we go. Beautiful, and now we're gonna bring the legs together. And you're gonna hold on to wherever you can hold on to. Your ankles, your calves, your feet, whatever it is. And we're gonna try, and I'm sorry I can't demonstrate more efficiently, but this is my body and I love it, so whatever. We're gonna try and bring the chest and belly to the thighs and the forehead to the shins as we lift the legs perpendicular to the floor. Nice, pulling in, good. And you can bend your elbows and pull a little closer. Excellent, good work, very nice. Nice hamstrings in the room. Good work, breathe. Good, good. And so I'm on this ab kick, so we're gonna bend the knees and go into the half boat. Good, and then go into the full boat. Good, and then the half boat. And roll your lower back into the floor. Good, and come down into the raft. Or in Kundalini yoga, I think they call this a stretch pose. So the feet are hovering above the floor a couple inches, just a couple. And we're reaching for the toes with our hands, and our chin is at our chest, and we're gazing at our toes. And we're gonna do breath of fire again. Here we go. Five, four, three, two, and one, and relax. Good work. Just rest. Your whole body comes down to the floor. Your head relaxes. Your shoulder blades are flat. The palms of the hands face up to the heavens. And the toes fall away from each other. As you inhale, feel your belly rise to the ceiling. And as you exhale, feel your belly sink into your spine. Big belly inhalation, feel your belly rise. Exhale, belly sinks into your spine. Inhale, rise up with the belly. Exhale, sink into the spine. Good. I want to do something, and it's a vinyasa thing that I've created. And I'll show you, and then Cheryl, if you need a modification or something else to do, I'll show you what else you can do. Because it will, you know, you're going to be rolling on your sacrum and your coccyx, but it's activating your abdominal muscles. So we're going to bring the chin to the chest. As we exhale, right, because we're contracting the body, we're reaching for the feet with our hands, and we peel our spine off the floor. And we inhale, lift up. And we exhale, close the body again like a clam. And now we're going to roll one vertebra at a time down onto the floor. Here we go, rolling down. And when the head reaches the floor, we're going to start inhaling, and the arms lift up over the body. Big inhalation. And as we exhale, we're going to push the lower back into the floor as we lift the legs all the way up off the floor. You can stay here, or you can reach all the way and touch the floor above your head with your toes. And then we're going to roll back down. So we're going to keep it moving. We're not going to keep stuck in any spot. Here we are inhaling because we're expanding the body. Good. Inhaling. Feet come to the floor. And then the hands lift up and reach for the toes, and the chin comes to the chest, and we peel the spine off the floor one vertebra at a time, and we scoop the air up. Inhale. Then we exhale as we close the body. And we're rolling one vertebra at a time back down to the floor, and we are expanding the body. So we inhale. And the arms lift up over the head, touch the floor. Push your lower back into the floor. And if this is too much, what I just did, you can lift one leg. And then the other. Otherwise, we're going to exhale. We're going to bring both legs up slowly. And we're going to reach them all the way up over the head. Touch the floor. Lift up. And rolling down. I'll do it one more time without speaking. And then I'll give you a modification, Cheryl, if you need it. Feet down. Close the body. Exhale. Reach for the toes. Peel the spine up. I guess I am speaking. Scoop the air out. Inhale. Lay down. Exhale. One vertebra at a time, rolling into the floor. Inhaling as we expand the body, arms up over the head. Exhale, feet one at a time or both. And stay here or reach all the way over your head. Touch the floor. Spike up and rolling down. Keep it moving. Okay, good. She's doing it. Cheryl, if you need a modification, give me a sign. You doing all right?
You're right. Time.
Okay, cool. Right on. Exhale. Scoop up. Lay down. Rolling back. Feel your abdominal muscles really engaging. Inhale. Exhale, feet up. Or foot up. Touch the floor. Spike up. Rolling down one vertebra at a time. Good work. Keep it moving. Just get lost in your breath. And get lost in the motion of what your body's doing. Peeling the spine off the floor. And if you're peeling the spine off the floor and you get stuck somewhere and you have to, you know, use something else, stay there for a minute because that's the exact spot where your abs need to be developed. And it's all perfect, right? Your body is this perfect organism that you just get to ride around in. You didn't make it, so don't take it personally. It's not you. But it really appreciates being taken care of and eating well and doing yoga. Everything you've ever put into your body or taken out of your body or everything you've ever done with your body and then your genetic structure has manifested into what it is today, and that's perfection. It's perfectly, it's doing exactly what you've intended it to do. We're gonna do three more. Just really enjoy it. Really enjoy this movement. Just be inside your body. Look at your bones. Look at the muscles as they expand and contract. Feel the beauty and the form and the motion. for your lower back. It's great if you have a tight butt. If you have sciatic nerve pain, this will open it up. Breathe and let your hands melt. Let your buttocks melt over your hands. Nice. And let her go in. All right, so we're going to lift the hips a little bit, and we're going to move the hands either up, down, in, out, somewhere else. I'm choosing to let them go right near the iliosacral joint. So my hands are even, so my sacrum is going to come into alignment. So let them melt. Beautiful. And then move your hands somewhere else. Surprise you how many tender little spots there are. Just enjoy that. And know that once you get up after this hour using your body in yoga, you're going to be walking more freely and sitting more freely and just passing through the world in a more graceful manner. One more time, hands go somewhere else. Good, and then lift your hips off of your hands. Keep your feet together, thighs open, and hands up over your head and just up in the air and stretch your fingers wide open. Put some blood back in there, roll your hands around on your wrists. All these joints are so important for everything we do. Roll your hands the other way. Good. Lay your arms down on the floor above your head. As you exhale, roll your lower back into the floor. As you inhale, roll your lower back off the floor, rocking on your sacrum. Exhale, roll the lower back down. Inhale, roll it up. Just feel your sacrum rocking on the floor, bringing everything into alignment. Check the time. Good, then bring your knees together and bring your feet up off the floor. Give yourself a big hug. You did a fantastic job. Bring your face to your knees. Give them a big kiss because you need them so much. I love you, knees. Good, and then holding on tight, hug tight, and then relax your head down to the floor. But don't let the grip on your legs go. Feels good. More deep stretch. Good work. Bring the arms out away from the body, palms down. Straighten the legs up in the air. Open the legs. Flex the feet. We're going to let the left foot come down to the floor by the left hand. When the foot touches the floor, the right leg engages and comes all the way down and touches the left leg. And then it lifts up. And the left leg is relaxed and the right leg's doing all the work as it reaches all the way over to the right side of the body and touches the floor. And the left leg engages when the right foot's on the floor. When the left foot touches the right foot, it lifts back up. So we're just moving side to side with the legs. And the legs don't touch until they're on the floor. So they're either working away from each other or toward each other. Up and exhaling over. And now let your head go in the opposite direction that your feet are going. Nice work. Up and over. Beautiful. Breathe. Just feel like you're out in the wheat field and you're a piece of wheat. If you don't like wheat because you have gluten intolerance, think of another beautiful grass that blows in the wind. Maybe a big field of sunflowers, or daisies, or dandelions, which the bees love in the spring. Bees need dandelions, so don't take them out of your lawn. Propagate them instead, is my opinion.
Just a little PSA for the bees. Up and over.
Next time your right foot comes to the floor and your left leg is on top of it, grab the left big toe with your right hand and roll the sole of the foot into the floor as you look down your beautiful long left arm. Feel the hip stretch. Beautiful, up and over the other side. Left leg lifts up, right leg doesn't engage until the left foot's on the floor. Right foot comes down to the floor. Left hand grabs the big toe, rolls the sole into the floor. Breathe. What happens if you relax your left hip a little bit more and your left leg? What happens if you turn your head a little bit more? Good, and then all the way up, inhale. Great work today. Good. Legs together, bend the knees, big hug. We're gonna do one more bridge just to get the abs stretched out again. Bring your heels to the floor, lift your belly up. Lift your hips up, feel your lower back arching, feel your shoulders stretching. Inhale, big Buddha belly. Exhale, Gandhi belly. And gently lower your body down to the floor. Good work. Feet come to the floor. Let's rock your knees from side to side. Rock your hands from side to side and your arms, and rock your head from side to side. And just let go of the floor with your feet and let them slide so that your legs gently straighten out as you rock from side to side, hips, shoulders, arms, hands, fingers, face, toes, whole body. It's like you're on a raft in a beautiful lake. There's a couple waves because a boat just went by. So you're in the wake and your body's rocking side to side as your legs straighten slowly out on the floor on the raft. Good. And when your legs are straight on the raft, we're going to push the heels out. We're going to pull the toes back. We're going to make fists with the hands. We're going to make fists. Squeeze the shoulders. Squeeze the arms, all the muscles in the arms. Squeeze your buttocks. Squeeze the legs. Squeeze your face, all the muscles in your face. Squeeze your shoulders up to your ears. Squeeze everything, all the muscles. Take a breath in. Exhale, drop. Relax every muscle in the body. And the lake is calm. And your body's completely supported by this beautiful raft as you breathe in and breathe out. Feeling the warmth of the sun shining down on your face. Warming every muscle in your face, feeling all the vitamin D coming into your body, keeping you healthy. Relaxing every little muscle around your eyes. Relaxing your jaw. Relaxing your sinus. All the face muscles are relaxing. Relaxing your toes and your feet and your ankles and calves and shins and knees and thighs. Relax. Relax your hips. Relax your belly as you feel the breath rolling in. And your belly rises and rolling out as your belly sinks down. Relaxing your chest muscles. Sometimes they get all tight when we start to panic about whatever issue that's going to disappear tomorrow anyway. Just let all those muscles relax. Relax your shoulders. Relax all the muscles in your arms and hands. Relax your neck. Belly rises and the belly falls as you breathe in and out, feeling the sun on the palms of your hands, feeling the sun on your legs and your toes and your chest and your belly, your whole body, receiving this beautiful energy from the sun. Watch as every pore in your body opens to the sun and draws that energy from the sun in as if you were a plant. And imagine you are a plant. What kind of plant are you? We're no longer an animal, now we're a plant. I want to be a rose bush. Feeling the sun on my leaves and my stem. As if I were a plant, I need roots, so let me see these roots growing from the soles of my feet into the earth. Down, deep down through the soil, all the way down to the water table, these roots reach. And every time a breeze comes by and flutters my leaves, the roots are activated to draw up the water into my roots and into the stem, all the way up into my leaves. Just notice, are there any buds on your plant? Is this a flowering plant that you've become? A flowering tree? Maybe you're algae, maybe you're a sea plant, I don't know. See buds on your plant. It's spring, spring is coming. San Diego. And watch as the sun shines on these buds, and watch as these buds are fed by the beautiful nutrients from the soil. And watch as the leaves are fed by all the carbon dioxide coming from all the people around you. All the nourishment, all the nutrients that you never will need is coming to you right now. The sun shines on the buds and they start to open. What color are your the buds, the flowers on your plant? Watch as they start to open. How does that feel in your body to have this beautiful flower appear? What does it smell like? Where are the flowers? Are they on the top of your plant? Are they in the bottom? Where do the flowers appear? What color are they? What texture are the petals? And now they're opening wide, and as if you could see the scent, the vibration of the aroma of the scent floating off, wafting off in the air, bringing goodness and that beautiful scent to all around. And look, someone catches a scent, it's a bee. And the bee is gonna come, it's attracted to the scent of your flower. Here it comes. And watch, there's pollen. There's a stamen and anthers, and the bee is gonna settle down with its beautiful little legs. And the bee is gonna do a little dance in this flower. It's so excited by what you've given it. It's so excited by this gift that you've given. This bee does a little dance, gathers pollen, those little legs, and nectar. Flies away. And just notice all these beautiful gifts, these beautiful flowers that you've given. The symbiotic relationship that we have with the earth. We belong to the earth. The earth doesn't belong to us, we belong to the earth. Just hold that beauty in your mind, take it with you. We have so many gifts that we give to each other and the earth and ourselves. Bring ourselves back into our body, into this physical animal form that we are in. Here we are, floating back into our physical form with our legs and our arms and our torso and our head and our bones and our blood and our tendons and our tissue and all the lymph in our nervous system. brain and our heart and our lungs. What a gift. Inhale long and deep. Feel the cool air coming in through your nose. Feel your belly rise with joy and exhale. And know that that exhalation, that carbon dioxide you give off, is going back to that plant. Inhale the oxygen that that plant gives you. Nice work. Wiggle your toes. Wiggle your fingers. Beautiful work. Keeping your eyes closed, just roll to one side gently. Rolling over one side. And with your eyes closed, push the floor away with your hand. And come sitting up gently, letting your spine become perpendicular with the floor. Feeling that energy from the base of your spine rising all the way up to the top of your head and beyond. Nice and tall. Good work. Bring the palms of your hands up and cover your eyes. Keep your eyes closed. Feel your spine is tall. And as you open your eyes beneath your hands, gaze into the infinite space. And gently lift your hands from your eyes and they focus on the palms and adjust the light in a nice gentle way. Bring your hands to your heart, to prayer mudra, beautiful work. Just feel that beautiful love in your heart, feel the warmth, knowing you've given yourself some new information about the gifts that you give to the world. And I'm going to say namaste to you all. Thank you for joining me and each other. And I'll see you next week. Yay!
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Sharon. See everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, Sharon. That was wonderful.
Yay! So good to see you, Cheryl. Bye, Erin.
Bye.
Tomorrow. Peace.